Hi, my name is John. Welcome to John's workshop. Today we'll be building a circuit board compatible with race coordinator. As it turns out, I've recently built such a circuit for my local club. These LEDs are here to help diagnose damaged optocouplers and so can be easily swapped. These terminals are inputs for each lane dead strip. On the other side are terminals for each relay logic and the last one for a yellow flag switch. Each of the optocoupler secondary is fed 5 volts. If detection is true, send a signal to each respective Arduino I/O. These terminals on the opposite side power the relays. I need to replace my current board as it got damaged last time I used it. Personally, I prefer to use strip boards as it relates to breadboards. You will notice how the terminals are currently placed diagonally, as they are not directly compatible with the strip board. Later I figured the legs can be manipulated to fit the board. Resistors here can be mounted either standing or flat. It is good practice to mark where to isolate before splitting the strips. I use a specific tool for splitting strips, but you can get away with a drill bit. I find it easier to split before soldering, as the solder can get in the way. Double checking everything before moving on will save you some time later. Soldering one IC socket pin from each side will help you to secure it in place and make it level. I will be building a similar circuit in a smaller footprint. Single core wires will be used in this build. At this point, I'm just double checking the space required to accommodate wires, resistors, splits, and headers. Same as the 6-pin socket, it's good practice to solder the extremities of headers before committing to solder all pins. Later on, what you see now will be changed as I was figuring out where and how I can place terminals and wires. Now is a good time to cut the board. Wires are color coded to each lane, same goes for the relay logic. The tricky part here is to allow enough length to run the wires from A to B. The board got a little too big, and that's the reason why it required further alteration, which I will be showing in the final result towards the end. Now it's time for some testing.
Yellow flag.
I'm using a 9-volt battery to trigger each lane.
Go! Driver 1 best lap. Driver 4 best lap. Yellow flag.
And now you can see the final product with the dead strip terminals placed in line with the board instead of diagonally. Terminals on the opposite side were removed to clear some room and replace with female headers. On my next video, I'll be showing the casing build and wiring you are currently seeing. If this video was useful to you, be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.